Hi everyone, I'm Shelley from There's No Place Like Home at redheadmom8.wordpress.com. As most of you who have been here before know, I am no fan of the public education system. I have brought it up on several of my homeschooling videos. I have devoted entire videos to my criticism of the public education system, and I have written many a blog post about it. And over the past few months, I've actually gotten some comments about this that has prompted me to make the video that I am sharing with you today, because I am not going to apologize for my public school stance. All right, well, over the past couple of months, I have had some people call to my attention the fact that as a homeschool mom, I should not be criticizing other educational methods. And, you know, one thing that I'm going to say about my channel and about my blog is that the entire reason that I decided to do my channel and my blog are because I am trying to help homeschooling parents to find a more relaxed, simple way of learning with their kids to bring peace to their homes. But I am also here to call out what I know are some of the really dark histories and methods of the public education system. So when people ask me not to talk about the public education system, here are my thoughts. There are a lot of homeschooling channels and blogs out there where the people will not talk about the public education system. Maybe they just aren't comfortable doing it, even if they feel the way that I do. Maybe they just really don't know. Maybe they just feel that it's not really in their place to do it. But as someone who has had my children in the public education system, besides me even being there, but having my own kids in the public education system, and then beyond that, all of the research that I have been doing on the history of public education, and just really keeping my eyes open to what is going on in the news all the time about this, I cannot in good conscience just zip my lips on this subject. It would actually be contrary to the entire reason that I started this channel. And I am not going to sell myself out like that. You know, one of the things that I am really passionate about is spreading truth. I am all about spreading truth. And what I have been seeing in our society lately is that truth is now supposed to take a back seat all the time to emotions. And I think that a lot of you can see where that has gotten us. So I to me, if it comes down to truth and emotions, truth is going to win every time. Does this mean that truth has to be brought about in a way that's nasty? No, I try to be straightforward about what public education really is like and what public education's true intentions originally were. But I try not to be demeaning in any way towards parents. I have never said, you're a terrible parent if you don't take your kids out of school. I have never, never said that because I don't believe that. What I am trying to do is to inform people. I am trying to inform anyone who will listen about the things that go on in schools. Because anyone who looks at the news today can see the sorts of things that are going on. There are teachers having relationships with their kids. There are fights all the time, which, you know, that has always kind of been a school thing, but it's up to this huge level now where kids are taking knives to school. You know, and this is even happening in areas around here. At the high school of the district that I am in, I think it was last year or the year before, a student actually punched a female teacher in the face and then pushed her down the bleachers. You know, besides that, we have all of this questionable curriculum going on in going around in the schools. Curriculum that has no business being in a school. The schools have decided that they are going to take over the role of parents, it seems. And they are starting to try to give their own version of what moral values to be to children despite the fact that a lot of parents are fighting against this. And if school holds true to what it claims to be, an academic institution to educate, teaching children about feelings and morals has no place there. That should be left to the parents. But I think that those of us who have looked into the history of education realize it's not about education. And I am not going to get into the whole history of a public school today. That's not what this channel is about, because I have done that several times. And I will link some videos in the description box below for you to watch if you are interested in that. But suffice it to say that I am not just some homeschooling parent who has never had my kids in school and doesn't really know much about the education system, and I'm just out there bashing people who do things differently than I do. No, that's not it at all. I used to love school, and I was completely taken in by what I thought it was supposed to be doing for me, until now as an adult I realize that a lot of the methods that were used in school have actually hindered me from being able to grow as an adult. I was a gifted student in school. I fit the school mold. And you would think that, hey, that would mean that I can do a lot of things now. But actually, it has really harmed me, because I've grown out of it through homeschooling. I have grown out of this. But for the longest time, I was unable to do anything unless people would tell me to do it. I was unable to do things unless people would tell me exactly how it was that I had to do it. It was like I had no training in finding information for myself. And that honestly is what is going on in schools today. Children are being fed information. They are not being taught critical thinking. They are not being taught how to find education. What is happening to them is they're being indoctrinated. It is a gigantic social engineering experiment. And you know, people can deny it all that they want, but truth be told, if you have actually taken the time to look into the history of education, you would see that no, that is exactly what it is. Schools were never put in place, compulsory schooling, I should add. I'm not talking about the one-room schoolhouses. Those were there for education. But once the compulsory school laws took effect and the schools were remade over into this Prussian model, yes, our schools were modeled after a Prussian form of schooling, which they put in place to train obedient citizens. So what did our people over here do? People like Rockefeller and Carnegie, what did they do? And there were others also, but what did they do? They took that and they implemented it into our own society because they needed factory workers. Pre-industrial revolution, I said I wasn't going to get into the history, but I've got to touch on it a little bit. Pre-compulsory schooling, we had a nation of entrepreneurs. We had a nation of people who were self-sufficient and were able to take care of themselves without having to worry about having a consumerist lifestyle. You know, look at us today. A lot of us don't know how to do the very basic things that we would need if our society would ever shut down. You know, how many of us know how to grow our own food anymore? How many of us know how to make our own clothing? How many of us would even know how to milk a cow? And I know, I realize that not everybody has farms, but the point is that what happened was those kids were taken out of their houses on purpose, because they did not want those kids to be trained in those self-sufficient lifestyles anymore. They wanted to take them away from that so that they could then start to be dependent on buying things, because people like Rockefeller were very concerned about overproduction. They wanted to make sure that there were always people there to buy their goods. So besides training these kids to be obedient factory workers, they were also training them to be mindless consumers who no longer knew how to care for themselves. And if you look at our schools today, yes, it is still going on. It looks different because we have a more modern society now, but that is exactly what has happened. Our society is entirely consumer driven, and kids, young adults, and I'd have to say a lot of people who are even older than that have completely lost the capacity to think for themselves. They just have no sense of critical thinking. There is no common sense left. And that's how we go right back to the schools are teaching feelings instead of facts. They are no longer teaching truth. That's where I come in. I know that not everybody is going to like what I have to say about school, and I know that every time that I post a video. And I am not out there doing it just so that I can offend people. I am truly doing it because I am hoping that I will at least wake some people up to the fact that school is not the best place for their kids. School is not what people think that it is. And if I have to risk making some people angry while I make these videos, I'm okay with that if I also know that I'm helping others to understand what the true history of our school system is, because it's not good. So anyway, that is all that I really wanted to share with you today is, you know, just to know that I am never going to back down about my stance about public education. That would be completely contrary to my character. How would I be helping people if I were to stifle the truth just because I didn't want to offend people? That's what's wrong with society today. We are afraid to speak the truth because we are afraid to offend people. And as we can see, that is not going to get us anywhere good. So I'm hoping that one day more people would start speaking out about the things that they have researched, because it's time we bring common sense back into our country. It's time we bring back a sense of real independence and people who truly know how to think for themselves. And I'm hoping to contribute to that by helping you to maybe learn that things aren't what they seem. Anyway, that's all that I have for you today. If you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet and would like to hear more of what I have to say, I would love if you would do that. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave one down below. And if you like my work, I encourage you to check out my Patreon page and see what rewards I have for you there. And I hope you have a great day.